amount of palms, eh?
Yeah, sure. I wonder where they collect them from.
Wow. I wonder if these are not also date palms. I don't know. Mist in the area here. We've got the sea, I think, on the left of us.
Yep.
Very calm there. With the wind.
Say
is.
Command.
These palm trees aren't looking too good.
No.
Ooh, I know.
They get beaten by the salt air, maybe, or whatever it is.
Maybe this is an elite area. Look at it. These are houses. Wow. The windows aren't very big there.
This is our campsite at Ultra Booker, Swakopmond. Very nice. You've got your own ablutions and wash up area. Great place to stay if you come to Swakopmund. The braai area and your dish washing section, hot and cold water. This is your shower. Very, very clean. Tile top to bottom, spotless. Wash basin, super clean. Everything is super, super clean. Guys, just busy making a bit of lunch. It's funny, when we arrived here, this whole place was covered in mist. It's now cleared. It's like it's somebody said to us, 2 o'clock, everything goes. Reception area. Ultra Booker. This is the pier at Swakopmund. Sun going down. Sun's nearly down. I think it's German architecture in Swakopmund.
Thank you.
This is a whole lot of pelicans in Walvis Bay. Albatross at the back there. This is a salt works here. We'll be driving through the pans
on the way to Sandwich Bay.
The salt production here must be huge. There's just so much of it around. We're going to load up onto some trailers here, and then it goes back to the salt works. Jeez, the rust thing must be huge here, huh? From all the salt.
Getting a pressure wash after we went on the salt road. Hopefully it gets all the salt off. Right, we're just leaving Swakopmund. Been drizzling this morning, a bit wet.
And foggy again.
And foggy again. So yeah. Luckily we had yesterday with a bit of sun for the pelicans and the flamingos.
We're on our way to Spitzkoppe. I'm sure the weather would clear there because it only seemed to be foggy and misty in Walvis Bay and Swakopmond. Swakopmund must be one of the cleanest towns I have ever been to.
Well, clean, Walvis Bay as well. It's just amazing.
In 500 meters, turn right onto Samnujoma Street.
As you drive along these little towns, they are spotless. The pavements are clean. It's just amazing. And it just shows if people just try a little bit, it can.
Yeah,
it's just, it's great, eh? Great to see a clean town. Well done to Swakopmund and Walvis. And these palms are beautiful along here as well, eh? All their roads seem to have palms in them. They must grow well in this area. Looks like this mist is going to clear. Sun is going to pop out, burn the mist away. By the time we get to Spitzkoppe, it'll be hot. Collect water when we go into Spitzkoppe and then fill up water tanks so that we got plenty of water for our shower at our camp, because there's no water in the camps, there's only a toilet. We're 5 kilometers from Spitzkoppe. You can see it in the far distance, I think. The road hasn't been too bad. What I can remember last time was worse than this. So we've been here a couple of times. Right, we're just coming up to Spitzkoppe now. It's a beautiful morning. We left Swakopmund, it was drizzling. But I think that's pretty normal for have that mist and drizzle in the morning. We're just coming up to the reception area. Rose is just going to go and book in here. We paid and everything is sorted out, eh? Just by the water there. Just by the water, none the whole thing. Okay, by the water thing. So we're just gonna pull up here with water, good water.
Are you going to fill the van as well?
Yeah, I'm going to fill the van to open up that.
Where's the keys?
The latch keys are in the car.
We're just going to go and see if we can find a nice campsite here. We do have one in mind.
This is the one where we saw the clips from the last
time. Yeah, that's right, eh? Mm. We were standing on the rock and we were spread in them, eh?
Yeah.
This is our campsite at Spitzkoppe. It's number 11A. Every time we've come here we've had this one. And it was also washing day. I think 3 or 4 days washing we had to get done. So we've done that. Cars getting a bit of shade now. From these rocks above. And that boulder just waiting to fall down. But it's been there for I don't know how many years, so it ain't gonna happen. Mrs. Douglas taking a snooze. Oh, Rosie. Taking a snooze.
Yes, well,
you think so?
Hot. Well,
30 degrees today, eh?
And yesterday was 14.
No, that wasn't.
Yesterday was so cold. Oh. This morning was cold.
Yeah. That's been our bed for the our bedroom for the last 3 weeks. Got our fan running off the inverter. No electricity at these campsites. But there is a drop loo. And there's no shower. So we collected water from the by the reception area there. And we're gonna put up our shower when it gets a bit. Yeah, fire pit. We might just do our fire there for our bra. We haven't got a lot of wood. That's a big bra. Or barbecue, other people would call it. Solar panel was putting in about 6 amps when we arrived here. Batteries are now sitting at 100%, eh? Thank you.
lots of these purple flowers around as well. Wherever we've been going, there's been lots along the side of the road. Very pretty as well. Another view of our campsite.
Sun is starting to go down. Hopefully we get some colour above the rocks and above our campsite here. We'll just have to look and see how it comes out. I don't know whether you can hear the starlings in the background at that nest of theirs.
This is the arch.
Biggest lizard I've ever seen this. Last time I was here with Rodney and Myra, I actually ran up here. This time I'm actually battling to get up here. So the years have gone by. Thank you. down on the opposite side. It is the easiest side to get up at from the back. Just making my way back to Rose on the opposite side. There's a cave here. Not enough room to stand up in, but it's enough room to sleep in for the bushmen in those days. Right, we're just walking up to see the caves here.
Mine not
really. Shit. The flies are a curse, eh? Jeez. Okay. Yeah. We got a picture of these.
Of you?
No. I didn't say of me, I said of these flowers. Here's a nice one over here.
Yeah.
All the green here. Beautiful, huh? Like, yeah.
Yeah.
Very pretty, eh?
I wonder why people haven't been coming here.
Nice big cave, this. Whoa, Jess.
What's it?
There was a bird in the nest here. I saw the droppings and I saw the tail.
It was this black one. It's just flown out to the tree. Has it got chicks in it?
Nah.